Today's video is the best pillow to help you sleep like a baby. I think many of us can agree that there's a sort of craze lately about mattresses. Mattress stores are popping up everywhere and people are excited. But let's not forget about that mini mattress for your head, your pillow. In the post I'm going to do today, I'm going to discuss different pillow types, which one works best for you, and what I prefer. So let's get started. So a long, long time ago, in a place far, far away, people were content sleeping on hay and using large stones as pillows. But times have changed. We've become a bit more civilized and sophisticated on the science of sleep. But all of this information actually just leads to confusion for many of us. You know, you ask yourself, should I buy a pillow, a soft pillow, because it would be like sleeping on a cloud? Or should I buy one with memory foam? Or should I get a firm pillow to support my neck? But the truth is, there is no one-size-fits-all. You have to first determine if you're a back sleeper, a side sleeper, or a stomach sleeper. Each position will put your neck into different mechanical stresses. Now, ideally, we would sleep on our back using a cervical pillow that you can buy at a chiropractic office. That's going to support the cervical lordosis, or that curve in the neck. Of course, we don't live in an ideal world, and many of us toss and turn at night. So for part of the night, we're sleeping on our backs, and then when we wake up, we're in a sort of military half-crawl stance with our heads turned to the right or the left. And that's actually how I sleep. So what pillow is the best? Well, I'm not going to promote any specific brands here, but I would opt for more pillow, so or more firm pillow, right? So look for support first and then the cooling aspect second. Now, some of you might not know what the cooling aspect is. A lot of pillows advertise this now, and mattresses advertise this. Some people complain of their pillows just being too warm. But the best answer I can give is just lower your temperature to 68 degrees in your room, which is the ideal sleeping temperature. And that should fix being too hot, right? Now, for someone who tosses and turns, again, that's me, the best pillow would be a buckwheat hull pillow. These pillows are sort of like, kind of like bean bags for your head. And, you know, you can be, they can be shaped and moved to conform to your position at that moment. You can't really do that with memory foam pillows or even your standard polyester pillow, which are usually really cheap. You can kind of do that with the polyester pillows, but they're not very firm, so it's just going to fall out of place eventually. And then speaking of memory foam, I'm really not a big fan of memory foam. I would use memory foam as a sort of padding if I was crash landing on Earth after an expedition to Mars, because that's what it was designed for, astronauts. NASA created memory foam, so now everyone wants to buy it and use it for everything. And I hope you're not crashing while you sleep. Memory foam is more protective as opposed to supportive, right? Your best option is a more firm pillow, which seems to be hard to find in stores because everyone thinks they want a memory foam or soft pillow. But like the whole pillow or even a pillow full of goose feathers, those are the best options for firm pillows. The problem with the quill feathers is you might, if you're not careful, you can get poked in the eye with one of those. So I would go with the buckwheat hull pillow. But that's basically it. You know, just kind of a brief overview of what I prefer and thinks best for most people. You can always buy two pillows, you know, one firm and one soft or memory foam, and go back and forth. I don't think there's a rule for having just one pillow. But anyway, I hope you enjoyed this post. Please like and comment and ask questions for future posts. And until next time, have a great day. Bye.